The Supreme Court, in case of Suresh Gupta and government of NCT, has held that for every mishap or death during a medical treatment, the medical man cannot be proceeded against for punishment. So we always afraid that something will happen and court will punish us. It is not true. Court also understand that medical profession is different other from the other professions and companies, that a raw material is passed and a fixed product comes out. It is not true. Whatever surgery you are doing, whatever treatment you are giving, the outcomes are different in different patients because of the body and the body response. So that is understood by the court, and so this decision is given, and so doctors are protected from this. Keeping in with the limitation of the time, we'll discuss only one civil case and one criminal case. What happens on the doctors, the cases, how they are, we will discuss only one, two cases only. In one case, negligence with a neonatal premature baby. This is the case decided in national forum. And we are deciding only those cases which are decided in national forum and other ROP case in the Supreme Court of India and national forum. They have decided finally, that is, the details of the case are the individual in the 29th week of a pregnancy. The birth weight of the premature baby was 1250 grams. The infant was placed in an incubator for 25 days and was administered 90 to 100% oxygen at the time of birth, underwent blood exchange transfusion a week after birth. The baby was 14 to 15 weeks of age but was not suggested a checkup of ROP. This is a not known thing of ROP in the previous days. Even ophthalmologist was not aware, not the pediatricians were not aware of the ROPs, but now it has changed the strategy and everybody is aware of the ROP because of that national, that case which has penalized 1,47,000,000 to the doctor and the organizations. So the expert opinion was asked, the ROPs starts developing from 2nd to 4 week after birth, when it is mandatory to do the first screening of the child. So this is to be advised by the pediatrician, and there should be note on the case paper that it is screening is advised, and there should be notes of the ophthalmologist that the pupil was dilated and the examination was done. Unless all these things are there, court never accept that the examination was not done. The medical literature suggests that stage 3 can be treated by the laser or cryotherapy treatment in order to eliminate the abnormal vessels. So in only stage 3, the treatment can be given. If it is passed, then treatment is useless. So all infants with a birth weight less than 1500 grams or gestation age less than 32 weeks are required to be screened for ROP. But the baby was not referred to a pediatrician ophthalmologist, which constituted a gross deficiency in services. So this becomes the gross deficiency of the services of the pediatrician, and if not examined, not detected, not treated, that of the ophthalmologist. So both are so the decision was ordered that compensation of 1,38,00,000 shall be paid by respondent number 1 and 4 within 3 months from the date of this judgment. Otherwise, the said sum should attract a penal interest at least of rate of 18%. So 18% rate, what you mean, you can understand how much it goes up. And the amount which is ordered is very beyond a capacity of a starting ophthalmologist practice. So all this has happened and attracted the towards the ROP, and the ROP screening has started at the government levels, organizations levels, and all the places. The amendment to the section, now another case, the amendment to the section 354 in the Indian Penal Code, the criminal law amendment, ordinance 2013 came into the force from 3rd February 1930. And since that, the male ophthalmologists were very much worried, and they are brought into the trouble, because doctor being a soft target, and particularly the men are very much afraid of all these things. They are made target by female patients, or not, I will not say patient, but females who wants to grab the money from them, because the amendment was in favor of them. What is that amendment? Section 354 in the Indian Penal Code, assert or criminal force to a woman with interest of outrage the modesty. The offense is cognizable, bailable, compoundable with the permission of the court by the woman asserted. Trial can be in the front of the. This clause, compoundable with the permission of the court by the woman asserted. So woman has a power to compromise or compound the offense, and so this clause has brought a lot of trouble, because she will say that no, nothing has happened. Okay, at the police station stage for something, police and the woman, if it goes in the court again, it happens the, with the permission of the court, she can compromise, and then the doctor comes into the trouble. So this clause is very much troublesome, the amendment. The case, State of Punjab, considered the question, what is the woman's modesty? It is held, the essence of a woman's modesty is her sex. The modesty of an adult female in writ large on her body, young or old, intelligent or immersible, awake or sleeping, the woman possesses a modesty capable of being outraged. Whoever uses criminal force to her with intent to outrage the modesty commits an offence punishable under Section 304. And because of this judgment, there are now, I am dealing so many cases, at least 3-4 cases against the ophthalmologist who has not done anything, but they are forced to pay, and the case is there. And this being a criminal case, everybody afraid and get settlement, want settlement. So this is in Marathi, but this is the actual statement given by a woman in this case, which I am dealing with this case. The Dole Tapaslyacha, if you understand the Marathi, you can read and go through. If you don't understand the Marathi, the she said that while examining on the slit lamp, doctor touched my leg, and because he touched with bad intention, it is a unmodesty, and the case started. The doctor has not done anything apart from this touching of her leg, whether he has touched or not touched, that is God knows. So act framed for the protection of a woman with all good intentions and motto. The intention of the law is not bad. All women are not bad. All things are not bad. But there are some people who take the advantage of the things, and doctors are coming into the trouble. But more often, misused and exploitation done by the fair sex. Under the grab of these protective sections, the complainants, the women, are harassing, blackmailing and frightening men beyond any imagination. So this is happening in small towns also. This is happening in big towns also. In big towns, it is very easy, throw the money and go. In small town, it becomes very difficult because everybody knows the doctor. So indemnity insurance policies should be taken for doctors and hospital with staff separately. And so, but indemnity insurance policies are only useful for ROP cases like that in Consumer Protection Act, but they are not useful in criminal cases. So it can be through directly, or it can be through a medical legal consultancy services, which gives you medical legal consultancy services in criminal cases and administrative cases, and also all the places wherever you require a consultation. And they also give the indemnity coverage of a nationalized insurance company. So when one can contact a medical legal company, whenever one receives a notice from advocate or court, whenever they receives a warrant, and all these things are there, when you can contact. Thank you very much.